The Lucy Show. Starring Lucille Ball. Co-starring Vivian Vance.
One more cup. You want it, babe, or should I throw it out?
Oh, I haven't made up my mind yet.
Well, since when does it take a Supreme Court decision about a cup of coffee?
Oh, I don't think so.
But on the other hand, now, maybe I will. No, I don't think so. Oh, babe, will you make up your mind? Do you want a cup of coffee or don't you?
Huh?
Do you want some more coffee?
Oh, I'm sorry, honey. I was going over my budget. Yeah, I'll have another cup of rust.
Very funny. I told you, the city's working on the pipes. That sediment in the water.
Well, I hope so, but my teeth are beginning to squeak.
What's all that figuring you're doing?
Oh, I'm just trying to make up my mind whether to buy a new coat or not.
Well, if you can afford it, buy it.
Well, it was either pay you the rent or buy a new coat, and thanks for making up my mind.
Well, you can just forget it then and pay your rent.
Oh, okay. I guess I can wear that faded, shabby, ratty old coat for one more year.
May I remind you that that faded, shabby, ratty old coat happens to be mine?
Oh, I forgot that.
You forgot that, yeah.
Well,
be careful what you throw down there now. You know how temperamental that disposal is.
Lucy, why don't you call a plumber?
Because I can't afford a plumber, that's why. Oh, it's stuck again. Oh, darn it, give me the broom, will you?
Oh, I still don't see why you don't call a plumber. That thing never works when you want it to. Oh. It just goes on and off like it had a mind of its own.
Oh, don't worry, I'll fix it. That ought to do it.
There goes old Faithful. Oh, Lucy, when are you going to call a plumber? I feel like I'm living in Yellowstone National Park.
If you would just stop throwing chicken bones in there, it wouldn't get clogged up.
Now, what would you like for me to do? Eat the bones and throw the meat in there?
I just ask you to be careful, that's all.
Okay, okay.
Yes, good. Remember that penny you gave me last week?
Yes, I remember that penny. Me and my wild impulses.
It says right here in my club collector's book that it's worth 50 cents.
Oh, you're kidding, really?
See here, it's a 1927 S. Lincoln penny.
Oh, Viv, he's right. That penny's worth 50 cents.
Jerry, how about splitting 50-50?
Oh, Viv.
Oh, I was only kidding.
Mom, I'm going right down to the coin dealers and sell it.
Okay, honey, but you be careful crossing Main Street.
Now that I've got 50 cents, I'll be extra careful.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Let me see that book, girl. Hey, look, there's a Lincoln penny worth $2.
Oh, there's one worth $10.
Lucy, listen to this. There's an 1877 Indian Head penny worth $800.
$800?
What's what I got here now? The penny. There's a penny.
I don't have any
penny
change at all.
It's a spade. No.
Let's see. How much is this dime worth?
A dime?
Dime. Just a minute.
A dime.
A nickel.
Let me see what
the quarter's
worth.
Wait just a minute. I find about this nickel.
Let me see what the quarter's worth.
Oh.
Oh, dear. And that's all I have.
Well, that cleans me out.
Oh, come on. We had to eat that cookie jar 2 weeks ago. What about your money for a rainy day?
It rained last week.
Gee, well, we need a big pile of money. Then maybe we'd get lucky.
Oh, the only place you could get a big pile of money today is a bank.
Mooney!
Miss Ferguson.
Yes, Mr. Moody.
Listen to what my horoscope has to say today. Planetary influences favorable. Financial gain imminent. A fine day for harmonious relationships. That sounds promising, doesn't it? Are you sure this is today's paper? Cancel my subscription. No, you cannot have an advance on your allowance. No, you cannot make a withdrawal on your Christmas club account. And no, your insurance dividend has not arrived.
Mr. Moody, we are here to make a business deal. It is surefire. It cannot miss.
Goodbye, Mrs. Carmichael.
Oh, now, Mr. Moody, just a minute. What kind of a banker are you to turn down a gilt-edged business deal without even knowing what it is?
Very well. What is it?
We want to borrow some money.
Everybody does. How much do you want?
Well, $20. We promise to pay the loan back within 24 hours.
With interest?
Yes.
With interest?
Yes.
Oh, what do you have as collateral?
Oh, how about my watch?
Mickey Mouse is one of my favorites.
I guess I put Jerry's watch on by mistake.
How about my watch? My ex-husband gave it to me for an anniversary present.
Those aren't real diamonds.
I know it. The only real thing my ex-husband ever gave me was a pain in the neck.
How about the two watches in my compact?
Oh, you're not going to give him your good jade compact.
Oh, that isn't jade. It's brass. It just turned that color.
What else have you got? Well, let's see. Here's three earrings.
And I got a Bowser bag with some spaghetti and meatballs. And I have a collapsible drinking cup.
And here's a jewel garter.
And here's a locket with Chris's hair. And, oh, here's Jerry's baby shoe. It's already made into a bag. Oh, and here is the medal I got for winning the broad jump in high school. Now, that certainly should be enough collateral for a $20 loan, Mr. Mooney.
I have seen better collateral in a gumball machine. I'll give you the $20 if you get this junk off my desk.
Oh, marvelous. Thank you.
Fine. Step this way,
oh,
lady.
Oh, great.
Thank you.
Oh, hey, wait a minute. That's mine.
What do you mean that's yours?
It is mine. I loaned it to you 2 years ago. I've been wondering where that drinking cup was.
Oh, for heaven's sake, I forgot about it. You know, you really thought this was jade, didn't you?
You always told it was jade. You said, that's jade when
I didn't want you to lose it.
That's my garter. That's yours. And these are my three earrings.
Yeah, well, one of those earrings is mine unless you have 3 ears. Yes.
Ladies,
yes.
If you'll step this way, we'll wind up this financial folder off.
Yes, sir.
Good.
Bill, let me have $20.
Here you are.
All right. Carmichael, there's your money.
Thank you very much.
Goodbye.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'll sign
the
contract. All right. Was there something else I could do for you?
We just want to change this $20 bill.
Oh, why didn't you say so? How do you want it? Ones, fives, ten?
Pennies.
Pennies. Pennies?
Yes.
2,000 pennies?
Well, yeah, if that's what it comes to.
If you're thinking of opening a bingo parlor at your house, and may I point out that it's illegal?
We are not thinking of opening a bingo parlor. Now, may we please have our pennies?
Oh, yeah. Will you give me 2,000 pennies, please?
Pennies?
Yeah, 2,000 pennies. I hope you know what you're doing.
Oh, we do, don't we,
dear? Oh, I should say we do.
Here you are.
Oh, thank you very much.
Oh, let's put it down on the floor,
Lucy. Hey, don't put it down. We won't be able to lift it up again.
Come on.
swing it up on the table. When I say three, swing it up.
Right.
And a one. And a two. And a... this mess. 2,000 pennies all over the kitchen.
Well, I'll clean them up, Lucy.
Oh, for heaven's
sake. I'll clean them up. Here, now, let's see.
Oh.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Deb, it'll take forever to do it that way.
Well, I'll get a broom.
Never mind. I got a better idea. Get that bench out of the way.
Okay.
Good heavens.
I thought I did want you to say three.
Put that in over there. Did I miss any, Viv?
No, sir. When it comes to finding money, we're better than the FBI.
Okay, you're gonna have to help me here. Hold on to this. It's so heavy.
Okay.
I'll pull it out up here, and then we gotta take it off.
Got it?
Can you get the bottom?
Uh-huh.
Oh, boy.
Flush. Lucy, why didn't you empty the dirt out of it?
Well, for heaven's sake, I can't think of everything.
Oh, now we'll have to put them in the sink.
Well, okay. Take it easy now. We don't want another disaster. Now, when I count to three, we'll... No. Never mind. Simply...
Oh, dear. Lucy, they're so dirty, we'll never be able to read the dates on them.
Well, we'll just have to clean them, that's all.
Yeah?
I'll wash and you dry. Clean money. There we are. You are not cleaning those one at a time, are you? Yeah. Oh, come on, Viv. Can't you go any faster?
No, I can't go any faster.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
Well, there goes old Faithful again.
Well, don't just stand there. Do something.
Well, how about my singing a couple of choruses of pennies from heaven? Or three coins in a fountain.
Vivian, stop blinking. I told you, it looks awful.
I can't help it. I got all kinds of spots in front of my eyes. They all look like pennies.
I looked at just as many pennies as you did, and I'm not blinking.
Lucy, let's just turn this in and go home, huh?
Nothing doing. Now, according to the law of averages, we should find a valuable penny in the next batch.
Oh, Mr. Mooney won't even give us another batch when he finds out that the garbage disposal scalped most of those Indians.
He probably won't even look in the bag, for heaven's sake.
The cash and carry girl.
Mr. Mooney, here's the $20 that we borrowed. We are returning it.
Well, that's the best news I've heard since my wife had laryngitis.
We kept our word, didn't we?
Yes.
Yeah, are you proud of it?
Oh, yes, yes. That's the way to keep your standing in the bank.
And our credit is still good.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, well, fine. Now we'd like to borrow $50.
$50? What do you have as collateral? Oh, no.
Now, Mr. Mooney, we proved that we are reliable. And if we're going to get anywhere at all in our business, we cannot possibly start with less than
$50. $50 is the absolute minimum.
Yes.
I'll give you 20.
We'll take it.
How do you want the money this time?
In pennies.
Pennies?
Yes.
Another 2,000 pennies?
What's wrong with these?
They were dirty. Yeah, I'm very surprised at a respectable bank giving out dirty money.
Yeah.
We won't spread it around town if you'll just give us 2,000 more.
No, we won't tell anybody. No.
Very well, but this is the last time.
Okay.
Yeah. Jim, another sack of 2,000 pennies, please.
Pennies?
Lucy, honestly, I don't think I can lug a bag full of pennies home again.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Hey, maybe we could use this table. Mr. Mooney.
Yeah, what now?
Could we use an end of this table? We won't bother anybody.
Those tables are reserved for the exclusive use of our customers.
Oh, heaven help me, you're a customer.
Look, would you tell me why you want this $20 in pennies? Why not dimes, quarters, halves?
I can't afford it.
Well, you ask a stupid question, you get a stupid answer.
You are, Mr. Mooney?
Oh, fine.
Oh, thank you.
Ah, don't you touch that.
I remember the last time. I'll do it for you.
Okay.
Here we are.
No.
1945D. No.
Oh, Viv, can't you ever say yes?
Yeah, when the right man asked me.
1950, no?
No.
1912S, no?
Yes.
1940. Viv, did you say yes?
Yes. Oh, that penny's worth $16.50.
$16.50. We got one.
Please, ladies, watch it. What do you think this is, a Watusi festival? You found one what?
A penny worth $16.50.
A penny worth $16.50?
That's right. And look, Mr. Mooney, right here there are 1,999 pennies. Now, let's see what we owe you.
Well, now, we owe him a penny for that one that we're taking.
That's right.
And we owe him 3 cents interest. That's 4 cents.
4 cents. All right, my good man. Here is a nickel. Keep the change. And thank you very much. This is an ordinary penny, but it's worth $16.50.
Ah.
That's $8.25 apiece.
That's right. Hey, we ought to do something to celebrate. Let's eat.
Okay. We'll eat right after we exchange the penny.
Oh, no, Lucy, let's eat now. I'd like a great big banana split and a double chocolate malt. Huh?
No, Viv, we'll get the $16.50 first and then we'll eat.
No, Lucy, come on. Let's eat first.
All right, we'll let our lucky penny decide. I'll flip it. And heads we exchange first, and tails we eat first.
Okay,
here we go.
Hi, Lucy.
Oh, hi,
Lucy. Lucy, you dropped it. Oh! It went down the storm.
Oh, no, I didn't.
Get to it, went right down the storm.
Oh, no, I didn't.
Now there was a penny worth $16.50.
Oh,
we'll never
no.
From Mr. Mooney.
Oh,
and we had
yeah.
to lug all those pennies home.
Oh, I know, Viv. I didn't mean to drop it down.
Now we had to pick them all up off of the floor.
I know, and all we went through together.
Then we had to clean
everything.
Them all, and then we got them stuck in the garbage disposal.
Over
we went through that whole thing, and now you got
it. I know, Viv. I know. I'm sorry.
What's the matter, lady?
I lost my penny.
Did she say she lost her penny?
That's exactly what she said.
Well, that's the first time in my life I've ever seen a grown woman cry over a lost penny.
Stick around, you're gonna see two of us bawl, because half of that penny was mine.
Lady.
Why?
If you stop crying, I'll give you a dime.
I don't want you a dime.
Now, you see what happened? I wanted to eat first. Now, if you'd have gone with me to eat first instead of flipping that penny up in the air.
It's right down there.
Where?
Right down there by a gum wrapper.
Oh,
now, you
really?
See, there's a silver gum wrapper, see?
Where?
See,
where?
Right down there. See over there by that gum wrapper?
Yeah.
See right there? See the silver one?
Oh,
right
yeah.
Right by the red one down there.
Yeah,
it's right in between. Put your hand down
there.
Yeah,
I see it.
You can get it.
I don't know
can
if I can reach it?
It
or not.
Come on, try. Maybe, let me stretch your arm, huh?
What do you think I am, a gorilla?
Oh, come on. Let me try.
Okay.
All right, folks. Come on,
stretch.
Break it up.
I don't know if I can reach it, Ben.
Come on, break it up.
If I can keep my eyes, if I can point to where it is,
okay, well, I can still see it, but I just can't.
Hey, you.
I just can't reach it.
You, down there.
Yeah. Somebody talk.
Oh, no. It's you two again.
Well, I lost my...
Yeah, I know, lady. You lost your penny.
Yes.
Have you two been hitting the happy sauce?
Officer, we have not been drinking. Come on, Lucy. We don't have to stay here and be insulted.
No, we certainly do not.
May I remind you that it's people like us who pay your salary?
And don't you forget happy sauce. Just because we happen to be lying in the gutter.
I just hope it works.
Oh, nobody's paying any attention to us. We look like workmen, don't we?
With manicures?
Put your glove on.
Oh, my glove. Yeah.
Now, come on, let's get going.
Well, one of us has got to go down there.
Yeah? Like I'm elected.
Okay.
You still see it?
Yeah, it's still there. Now you know where it is now, Lucy.
Yeah, I can see
now,
it.
Hurry up now, because I'm getting nervous.
You're nervous. I'm afraid I'm gonna get the bends.
Oh, okay, you ready?
Yeah, will you hold on to me?
Sure. I'll get your feet.
Well, hiya, fellas. What's up?
Hi, officer.
We're just fixing this place down here. Just a usual checkup, you know.
Oh, I see. Well, I hope you don't tie up traffic too long.
Oh, no, it would take no longer than usual.
All right, just to get home a wife and kids.
Oh. Okay, fellas.
Oh, boy, that was a close one. Get started again. Now, I'll get your feet. I'll get your feet, and I'll reel you out. Right
there.
Can you see anything?
No, it's too dark.
What?
It's dark in here.
Oh, don't worry, honey. I'm out here.
I can't see anything. Give me the flashlight.
The flashlight?
Yeah.
Okay.
What's the matter, fellas?
I lost my penny.
front of my eyes. They all look like pennies. I looked at just as many pennies as you did, and I'm not blinking. Lucy, let's just turn this in and go home, huh? Nothing doing. Now, according to the law of averages, we should find a valuable penny in the next batch. Oh, Mr. Mooney won't even give us another batch when he finds out that the garbage disposal scalped most of those Indians. Probably won't even look in the bag, for heaven's sake. Come on.
Uh-oh. The cash and carry girl.
Mr. Mooney, here's the $20 that we borrowed. We are returning it.
Well, that's the best news I've heard since my wife had laryngitis.
We kept our word, didn't we?
Yes.
Yeah, are you proud of it?
Oh, yes, yes. That's the way to keep your standing in the bank.
And our credit is still good.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, well, fine. Now we'd like to borrow $50.
$50? What do you have as collateral? Oh, yeah, no.
Now, Mr. Mooney, we proved that we are reliable. And if we're going to get anywhere at all in our business, we cannot possibly start with less than
$50. $50 is the absolute minimum.
Yes.
I'll give you 20.
We'll take it.
How do you want the money this time?
In pennies.
Pennies?
Yes.
Another 2,000 pennies? What's wrong with these?
They were dirty.
Yeah, I'm very surprised at a respectable bank giving out dirty money.
Yeah. We won't spend it around town if you'll just give us 2,000 more.
No, we won't tell anybody. No.
Very well, but this is the last time.
Okay.
Yeah. Jim, another sack of 2,000 pennies, please.
Pennies?
Pennies?
Lucy, honestly, I don't think I can lug a bag full of pennies home again.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Hey, maybe we could use this table. Mr. Mooney.
Yeah, what now?
Could we use an end of this table? We won't bother anybody.
Those tables are reserved for the exclusive use of our customers.
Oh, heaven help me, you're a customer.
Look, would you tell me why you want this $20 in pennies? Why not dimes, quarters, halves?
I can't afford it.
Well, you ask a stupid question, you get a stupid answer. You are, Mr. Mooney?
Oh, fine.
Oh, thank you.
Ah, don't you touch that. I remember the last time. I'll do it for you.
Okay.
Here we are.
1944.
No.
1945D.
No.
Oh, Viv, can't you ever say yes?
Yeah, when the right man asked me.
1950. No.
No.
1912S. No.
Yes.
1940. Viv, did you say yes?
Yes. Oh, that penny's worth $16.50.
$16.50. We got one. We got one.
Please, lady, watch it. What do you think this is, a Watusi festival? You found one what?
A penny worth $16.50.
A penny worth $16.50?
That's right. And look, Mr. Mooney, right here there are 1,999 pennies. Now let's see what we owe you.
Well, now we owe him a penny for that one that we're taking.
That's right.
And we owe him 3 cents interest. That's 4 cents.
4 cents. All right, my good man. Here is the nickel. Keep the change and thank you very much. Is an ordinary penny, but it's worth $16.50.
Ah.
That's $8.25 a piece.
That's right. Hey, we ought to do something to celebrate. Let's eat.
Okay. We'll eat right after we exchange the penny.
It's the Lucy Show. Starring Lucille Ball. Vivian Vance.
coffee left for about one more cup. You want a bib or shall I throw it out?
Oh, I haven't made up my mind yet.
Well, since when does it take a Supreme Court decision about a cup of coffee?
Oh, I don't think so.
But on the other hand, now, maybe I will. No, I don't think so. Oh, will you make up your mind? Do you want a cup of coffee or don't you?
Huh?
Do you want some more coffee?
Oh, I'm sorry, honey. I was going over my budget. Yeah, I'll have another cup of rust.
Very funny. I told you, the city's working on the pipes. That sediment in the water.
Well, I hope so, but my teeth are beginning to squeak.
What's all that figuring you're doing?
Oh, I'm just trying to make up my mind whether to buy a new coat or not.
Well, if you can afford it, buy it.
Well, it was either pay you the rent or buy a new coat, and thanks for making up my mind.
Well, you can just forget it then and pay your rent. Oh, okay.
I guess I can wear that faded, shabby, ratty old coat for one more year.
May I remind you that that faded, shabby, ratty old coat happens to be mine?
Oh, I forgot that.
You forgot that, yeah. Well, sheesh. Be careful what you throw down there now. You know how temperamental that disposal is.
Lucy, why don't you call a plumber?
Because I can't afford a plumber, that's why. Oh, what's stuck again? Oh, darn it. Give me the broom, will you?
Oh, I still don't see why you don't call a plumber. That thing never works when you want it to. Oh. It just goes on and off like it had a mind of its own.
Oh, don't worry. I'll fix it. That ought to do it.
Like I'm living in Yellowstone National Park.
If you would just stop throwing chicken bones in there, it wouldn't get clogged up.
Now, what would you like for me to do? Eat the bones and throw the meat in there?
I just ask you to be careful, that's all.
Okay, okay.
Yes, good. Remember that penny you gave me last week?
Yes, I remember that penny. Me and my wild impulses.
It says right here in my coin collector's book that it's worth 50 cents.
Oh, you're kidding, really?
See here, it's a 1927 S. Lincoln penny.
Oh, Viv, he's right. That penny's worth 50 cents.
Jerry, how about splitting 50-50?
Oh, Viv.
Oh, I was only kidding.
Mom, I'm going right down to the coin dealers and sell it.
Okay, honey, but you be careful crossing Main Street.
Now that I've got 50 cents, I'll be extra careful.
Whoa. Let me see that book, girl. Hey, look, there's a Lincoln penny worth $2.
Oh, there's one worth $10.
Lucy, listen to this. There's an 1877 Indian head penny worth $800.
$800?
Oh. What I got here now. The penny. There's a penny.
I don't have any
penny.
Change at all.
Oh, no, Lucy, let's eat now. I'd like a great big banana split and a double chocolate malt, huh?
No, Viv, we'll get the 16.50 first and then we'll eat.
No, Lucy, come on, let's eat first.
All right, we'll let our lucky penny decide. I'll flip it. And heads we exchange first and tails we eat first.
Okay.
Okay, here we go.
Hi, Lucy.
Oh, hi. Hi,
Lucy.
From Mr. Mooney.
Oh,
then we
yeah.
had to lug all those pennies home.
Oh, I know, Viv. I didn't mean to drop it down.
Then we had to pick them all up off of the floor.
I know, and all we went through to get
them. Then we had to clean them all, and then we got them stuck in the garbage disposal.
Over
we
everything.
Went through that whole thing, and now you got
it. I know it, Viv. I know. I'm sorry.
What's the matter, lady?
I lost my penny.
Oh, Did she say she lost her penny?
That's exactly what she said.
Well, that's the first time in my life I've ever seen a grown woman cry over a lost penny.
Stick around, you're going to see two of us bawl, because half of that penny was mine.
Lady.
What?
If you stop crying, I'll give you a dime.
I want you a dime.
Now, you see what happened? I wanted to eat first. Now, if you'd have gone with me to eat first instead of flipping that penny up in the air. Lucy? Lucy, I see it.
Where?
It's right down there.
Where?
Right down there by a gum wrapper. Oh, now, you see, really? There's a silver gum wrapper, see?
Where? Where?
Right down there. See over there by that gum wrapper?
Yeah.
See right there? See the silver one?
Oh,
right,
yeah.
Right by the red one down there.
Yeah,
it's right in between. Put your hand down.
Yeah, I see it.
You can get it.
I don't know
can
if I can reach it or
not. Come on, try. Maybe, let me stretch your arm, huh?
What do you think I am, a gorilla?
Oh, come on. Let me try.
Okay.
All right, folks. Come on,
stretch.
Break it up.
I don't know if I can reach it, Ben.
Come on, break it up.
If I can keep my eyes, if I can point to where it is,
okay, well, I can still see it, but I just can't.
Hey, you.
I just can't reach
you,
it.
You, down there.
Yeah. Somebody talk.
Oh, no. It's you two again.
Well, I lost my...
Yeah, I know, lady. You lost your penny.
Yes.
Have you two been hitting the happy sauce?
Officer, we have not been drinking. Come on, Lucy, we don't have to stay here and be insulted.
No, we certainly do not.
May I remind you that it's people like us who pay your salary?
And don't you forget it. Happy sauce. Just because we happen to be lying in the gutter.
I just hope it works.
Oh, nobody's paying any attention to us. We look like workmen, don't we?
With manicures?
Put your glove on.
Oh, my glove.
Yeah. Come on, let's get going.
Well, one of us has got to go down there.
Yeah? Like I'm elected.
Okay.
You still see it?
Yeah, it's still there. Now, you know where it is now, Lucy.
Yeah, I can see
now,
it.
Hurry up now, because I'm getting nervous.
You're nervous. I'm afraid I'm going to get the bends.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah, will you hold on to me?
Sure. I'll get your feet.
Well, hiya, fella.
Yeah. No. Let's see. How much is this dime worth?
A dime?
Dime, just a minute. A dime.
A nickel.
Let me see what
this quarter's
worth.
Wait just a minute, I find about this nickel. No,
no. Let me see what the quarter's worth.
Oh. Oh, dear, and that's all I have. Well, that cleans me out.
Oh, come on, we emptied that cookie jar 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
What about your money for a rainy day?
It rained last week, remember?
Gee, well, we need a big pile of money. Then maybe we'd get lucky.
Oh, the only place you could get a big pile of money today is a bank.
Mooney!
Miss Ferguson.
Yes, Mr. Mooney?
Listen to what my horoscope has to say today. Planetary influences favorable. Financial gain imminent. A fine day for harmonious relationships. That sounds promising, doesn't it? Are you sure this is today's paper? Cancel my subscription. No, you cannot have an advance on your allowance. No, you cannot make a withdrawal on your Christmas club account. And no, your insurance dividend has not arrived.
Mr. Mooney, we are here to make a business deal. It is surefire. It cannot miss.
Goodbye, Mrs. Carmichael.
Oh, now, Mr. Lewis, just a minute. What kind of a banker are you to you turn down a gilt-edged business deal without even knowing what it is?
Very well. What is it?
We want to borrow some money.
Everybody does. How much do you want?
Well, $20. We promise to pay the loan back within 24 hours.
With interest?
Yes.
With interest?
Yes.
Oh, what do you have as collateral?
Oh, how about my watch?
Mickey Mouse is one of my favorites.
I guess I put Jerry's watch on by mistake.
How about my watch? My ex-husband gave it to me for an anniversary present.
Those aren't real diamonds.
I know it. The only real thing my ex-husband ever gave me was a pain in the neck.
How about the two watches in my compact?
Oh, you're not going to give him your good jade compact.
Oh, that isn't jade. It's brass. It just turned that color.
Well, let's see. Here's three earrings.
And I got a Bowser bag with some spaghetti and meatballs. And I have a collapsible drinking cup.
And here's a jewel garter.
And here's a locket with Chris's hair. And, oh, here's Jerry's baby shoe. It's already made into a bag. Oh, and here is the medal I got for winning the broad jump in high school. Now, that certainly should be enough collateral for a $20 loan, Mr. Mooney.
I have seen better collateral in a gumball machine.
Give us the $20.
I'll give you the $20 if you get this junk off my desk.
Oh, marvelous. Thank you.
Fine. Step this way, lady.
Oh, great. Thank you. Oh, hey, wait a minute. That's mine.
What do you mean that's yours?
It is mine. I loaned it to you 2 years ago. I've been wondering where that drinking cup was.
Oh, for heaven's sake, I forgot about it. You know, you really thought this was jade, didn't you?
You always told it was jade. You said, that's jade when I
wanted to borrow it. Well, I didn't want you to lose it.
That's my garter, and that's yours. And these are my three earrings.
Yeah, well, one of those earrings is mine unless you have 3 ears. Yes.
Ladies,
yes.
If you'll step this way, we'll wind up this financial falderal.
Yes, sir.
Bill, let me have $20.
Here you are.
All right. Carmichael, there's your money.
Thank you very much.
Goodbye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'll
sign for
that. All right. Was there something else I could do for you?
We just want to change this $20 bill.
Oh, why didn't you say so? How do you want it? Ones, fives, ten?
Pennies.
Pennies.
Yes.
2,000 pennies?
Well, yeah, if that's what it comes to.
If you're thinking of opening a bingo parlor at your house, and may I point out that it's illegal?
We are not thinking of opening a bingo parlor. Now, may we please have our pennies?
Oh, yeah. Will you give me 2,000 pennies, please?
Pennies?
Yeah, 2,000 pennies. I hope you know what you're doing.
Oh, we do, don't we,
dear? Oh, I should say we do.
Here you are.
Oh, thank you very much. Out of the way.
Okay.
Good heavens.
I thought I did what you said. Great.
Plug that in over there.
Oh,
us any, Viv?
No, sir. When it comes to finding money, we're better than the FBI.
Okay, you're gonna have to help me here. Hold on to this. It's so heavy.
Okay.
I'll pull it out up here, and then we gotta take it off.
Oh! Got it?
Can you get the bottom?
Yeah. Oh, boy!
Flush!
Lucy, why didn't you empty the dirt out of it?
Well, for heaven's sake, I can't think of everything.
Oh, now we'll have to put them in the sink.
Well, okay. Take it easy now. We don't want another disaster. Now, when I count to three, we'll... No. Never mind. Sip, quick.
Oh, dear. Oh, Lucy, they're so dirty, we'll never be able to read the dates on them.
Well, we'll just have to clean them, that's all.
Yeah?
I'll wash and you dry. Nice, clean money. There we are. You are not cleaning those one at a time, are you? Yeah. Oh, come on, Viv. Can't you go any faster?
No, I can't go any faster.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
Well, there goes old Faithful again.
Well, don't just stand there. Do something.
Well, how about my singing a couple of choruses of Pennies from Heaven? Or three coins in a fountain.
Vivian, stop blinking. I told you, it looks awful.
No, I don't think so.
Oh, will you make up your mind? Do you want a cup of coffee or don't you?
Huh?
Do you want some more coffee?
Oh, I'm sorry, honey. I was going over my budget. Yeah, I'll have another cup of rust.
Very funny. I told you, the city's working on the pipes. That sediment in the water.
Well, I hope so, but my teeth are beginning to squeak.
What's all that figuring you're doing?
Oh, I'm just trying to make up my mind whether to buy a new coat or not.
Well, if you can afford it, buy it.
Well, it was either pay you the rent or buy a new coat, and thanks for making up my mind.
Well, you can just forget it then and pay your rent. Oh, okay.
I guess I can wear that faded, shabby, ratty old coat for one more year.
May I remind you that that faded, shabby, ratty old coat happens to be mine?
I forgot that.
You forgot.
It's the Lucy Show. Starring Lucille Ball. Co-starring Vivian Vance.
Left for about one more cup. You want it, Viv, or should I throw it out?
Oh, I haven't made up my mind yet.
Well, since when does it take a Supreme Court decision about a cup of coffee?
Oh, I don't think so. But on the other hand, now, maybe I will.
Yeah. Well. Sheesh. Be careful what you throw down there now. You know how temperamental that disposal is.
Lucy, why don't you call a plumber?
Because I can't afford a plumber, that's why. Oh, what's stuck again? Oh, darn it. Give me the broom, will you?
Oh, I still don't see why you don't call a plumber. That thing never works when you want it to. Oh. It just goes on and off like it had a mind of its own.
Oh, don't worry. I'll fix it.
That ought to do it.
I'm living in Yellowstone National Park.
If you would just stop throwing chicken bones in there, it wouldn't get clogged up.
Now, what would you like for me to do? Eat the bones and throw the meat in there?
I just ask you to be careful, that's all.
Okay, okay.
Dan, remember that penny you gave me last week?
Yes, I remember that penny. Me and my wild impulses.
It says right here in my coin collector's book that it's worth 50 cents.
Oh, you're kidding, really?
See here, it's a 1927 S. Lincoln penny.
Oh, Viv, he's right. That penny's worth 50 cents.
Jerry, how about splitting 50-50?
Oh, Viv.
Oh, I was only kidding.
Mom, I'm going right down to the coin dealers and sell it.
Okay, honey, but you be careful crossing Main Street.
Now that I've got 50 cents, I'll be extra careful.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Let me see that book, girl. Hey, look, there's a Lincoln penny worth $2.
Oh, there's one worth $10.
Lucy, listen to this. There's an 1877 Indian Head penny worth $800.
$800?
Oh. What's what I got here now? The penny. There's a penny.
I don't have any
penny.
Change at all. No, let's see. How much is this dime worth?
A dime?
Dime, just a minute.
A dime.
A nickel.
Let me see what
the quarter's
worth.
Wait just a minute, I find about this nickel.
No,
let me see what the quarter's worth.
Oh. Oh, dear, and that's all I have.
Well, that cleans me out. Oh, come on. We emptied that cookie jar 2 weeks ago.
Yeah. What about your money for a rainy day?
It rained last week.
Gee, well, we need a big pile of money. Then maybe we'd get lucky.
Oh, the only place you could get a big pile of money today is a bank.
Mooney!